Saudi Arabia Floating Turtle City. Saudi Arabia is no stranger to mega projects, record-breaking activities and events in mega hotels. With Neom, King Salman Park, Hotel Air Balloon Hotels, Trojena, and many more musty attractions on the way. But just when we all thought there couldn't possibly anymore, the nation has unveiled yet another astounding project. A floating turtle city. Yeah, you heard correctly, the Kingdom of Saudi Arabia intends to build a turtle-shaped floating city. In today's video, we'll tell you all about this project, which is currently one of the most fascinating projects going on right now. Before we jump in, make sure to subscribe to our channel for more videos on mega projects around the world. Saudi Arabia will soon be home to a 5 billion tetra yacht titled Pangeos. The Italian design studio Lazzarini proposed and designed Pangeos, which takes its name from Pangea, the supercontinent that existed millions of years ago during the late Paleozoic and early Mesozoic eras. Pangeos' proposed size is truly enormous. The vessel would be the biggest floating structure ever when it's finished. The German-built Azam, which is 180 meters long, currently holds the title of largest yacht in the world. The Seawise Giant, built by the Japanese company Sumitomo Heavy Industries, was the largest sea vessel ever built and was 458 meters long. Both of these giants would be greatly dwarfed by the Pangeos. Like we already mentioned, the enormous sea vessel will serve as a floating city. Now, there'll be enough room for public areas like parks, shopping malls, and hotels. According to Lazzarini, Pangeos will hold 60,000 guests in addition to an unspecified number of crew and staff. There would be 69 apartments and 19 villas on each of Pangeos' side wings, and a rooftop shell will have 72 terraces available, while others will look out over the ship's main port. Some will have views of the ocean. Pangeos will include a rooftop garden, a mall, and a beach club, as well as a 650 meter wide by 600 meter long terashipyard infrastructure with direct access to the sea. In addition, the vessel will include 9 different bows, each of which is further divided into a number of blocks. The bows start at the port's area's entrance and lead to the main square. From there, they extend into a large terraced villa, and then onto private homes, structures, and rooftop terraces. On board, an area called the upper shell area will allow access to flying vehicles, and a port will be built for the other boats. The design's team basement contains 30,000 cells or cluster compartments and offers an unskinnable floating solution that is intended to be primarily realized in steel. The Pangeos is anticipated to have a top speed of just 5 knots, propelled by 9 16,800 horsepower HTS engines. The ship's slow, steady pace makes sense given its massive weight. As for guests, a choice of using either a different sea vessel or an aircraft will be available to those who wish to travel between Pangeos and other locations. Although Pangeos is being constructed for Saudi Arabia, it is built to sail nonstop around the globe because it will be equipped with practically limitless green energy resources. In contrast to a typical cruise ship or yacht, the vessel itself would be the main attraction. The Terayacht project is likely to be located at the King Abdullah Economic City, some 2 kilometers from the King Abdullah port. As regards funding and construction, it comes no surprise that constructing a floating city of this size will be extraordinarily expensive. According to Lazzarini, the development of Pangeos will require an investment of $8 billion. Also, the construction would take place over an 8-year period, even though the interiors of Pangeos have not yet been made public. For construction to start, a section of the sea that is about 1 square kilometer in size would need to be dredged. Water levels would also be managed at the construction site using a circular dam. In order to raise money, there is an NFT crowdfunding initiative, according to Lazzarini. The virtual spaces of the watercraft can also be purchased under an NFT collection, adding that users will need to collect specific content and use their login credentials to access the virtual properties. According to the design studio, the same credentials will also serve as a property deposit in the event of a real construction. Are you ready to dive in? Comment below and let us know. You may also subscribe to our channel for more fascinating videos and futuristic architecture. And while you're at it, do well to give this video a thumbs up, and see you next time.